All right, been getting tons of questions. How do we put the screws in the China trucks? And I understand it's not an easy feat, but I'm gonna give you some tips and tricks. Got a sticker on me. Gonna give you some tricks and tips to getting the screws into China trucks, no problem. Also, small announcement, you're going to be stocking a handful of black opal bushings so you can fully tune out your trucks. So, to get started, we're going to take this tool, get rid of that. You need a handheld screwdriver for this. I've never even attempted it with the tiny tool because once you see what I do, you're going to realize, yeah, you definitely need a bigger tool for this. So I've already got some stuff prepped here. Gonna need the screws that it comes with, and I'll get more into the tuning here in a minute. So what you're gonna do is take your truck, no wheels, no nothing on it yet, and these are not pre-threaded, so you're gonna want to do this. This is just a lot easier. So what you do is you take your screw and you get your handheld screwdriver so you can get more torque. Damn light turned off. I don't know if that's gonna affect the video. Okay, we're back. You're gonna take the screw with your handheld screwdriver and you're gonna screw it through the holes without even putting it on the board yet. Because what you're doing here is you're gonna thread the holes. And it takes quite a bit of force. You already heard it click there. And you just screw it down until it's through the truck. And you try and do this as straight as possible. It's easy, pretty easy to correct it if it's going in crooked. And then just back that screw out. And what I do is I just use the same screw over and over. I mean, you can use a different screw if you want. And you're gonna do that to all 8 holes. I hear footsteps. We're good. See, you just go through and you're gonna thread it through all the holes. And it's not easy. I mean, I'm not gonna lie to you. It's pretty tough. But once you get it through, you only need to do this once. Got a lot of clicking going on. Sometimes you get a bad screw that has paint in it. What kind of annoys me, you know, a lot of people like yell at me for the quality of trucks, and it's like, I don't make these things, you know. If I made them, they'd be way better quality. And that's not to say that these are bad trucks. These are actually really good trucks. You just got to go through this pain in the butt to get these threaded. But once they're threaded, man, they're really great trucks once you tune them up. So yeah, just kind of play with the positioning in your hand, find what feels comfortable. And you just screw that screw in. I don't know how well this is gonna zoom in or how well we're lit. You just screw in until it's in. And then you back it on out. And you do it to all the holes. Probably just repeating myself. Can't tell which ones I've done and haven't done yet. The painted trucks are a little bit easier to tell, but I'm kind of struggling with my lighting right now. Yeah, I already did that one. That feels nice and easy. I think it's fair to say I did all 4 of these. Kind of doing this video on a whim. Trying to do it quickly. But yeah, I mean, it takes a lot of force. And it kind of tickles your fingers. But yeah, once that's done, we're good to put it on the board. So, same thing as always. I already got this pre-gripped and hold. So now you're going to put it on the board. And sometimes the threading goes perfectly well and you don't need to do any other tricks. But also what I'm gonna show you, see, so it just grabbed a thread. It's not really holding on much. As you can see, I can swing the truck around. It's just barely grabbing the thread, and then I put in a second screw to square it up. This stupid screw would cooperate. There you go. and felt it grab. And I just go as tight as I can. You hear that click, that means it's probably as tight as you're gonna get it by pressing like this. It's still gonna take a little bit of torque. It's pretty much impossible to overdo this, I feel like. So I just get them in all hand tight. And after that, I checked to see how deep they went in. So the screw should be at least flush with the base plate here. And if it's not, that means you probably didn't thread it the best. And that's okay, because now what you're gonna do before you have wheels on and stuff, I don't wanna do this on that. You just take the board and you put it flat on the ground. So I'm pretty sure this one isn't in all the way. And you can really apply pressure down and screw it on. Boom, that one's on. And I go ahead and I do all four just till I feel it's on there good and tight. And double check and make sure. Yeah, perfect. They're just barely past the base plate, which I know that means they're all the way in. I can't see any air between the base plate and the truck. That means you did it. That is what works best for me. And I always get messages all the time asking, how the hell do you get these things on? And it's just, you really need to upgrade your screwdriver. I really don't think you can do that with the tiny screwdriver it comes for free with. I only use that tool pretty much just for the lock nuts. To me, that's all that tool's good for. And you can get this at any hardware store. You can even get it at like Walgreens and stuff. And this was $5 and this was a fancy one. It's got a ratchet attachment, whatever thingy. $5. Way worth it. Again, the easiest way to tell that you have it all the way on, you can't see any air between the truck and the board. It's nice and tight. You know, it's not going anywhere. I'm just now realizing I've probably tightened this guy up just a fuzz. Just a quarter turn. Perfect. That's that. Now, probably gonna already have these on the shop by the time I post this video, but I teamed up with Black Opal Tuning and he's gone on ahead and supplied me with a handful of bushings for you guys. And so what they're gonna come with, I'll have these as like a separate item on the shop. They're gonna come with one set of green, one set of blue. Boom, two sets of bushings. And these are great bushings. They're a little bit skinnier, which is kind of what I like. I totally scripted throwing that first tool and put another one in my pocket. And the way I do these with the Black Opal Tuning is I keep the top washer that the trucks come with, but I get rid of the bottom washer. I think it just takes up too much space. I should also say, I like my trucks pretty loose. So, I mean, you can just play with it, you know? If you like it with the with that bottom washer in, leave the bottom washer in. Just play with it. See what feels best. But I don't. I toss the bottom washer out, and I keep the top washer. I just feel like it helps keep everything stay squared up and looking good. And I get it. Get that lock nut on until I feel it just barely stop the lock into place. And look at that turn. Beautiful. Love these things. And I just realized I don't have hardware for wheels. Because I'm a dingleberry. Why am I a dingleberry? That's gross. Yeah, just gonna do this real quick. There's a million and one ways of doing this, guys. So you do whatever feels best for you. I'm just telling you what I do. Oh, there's that top washer. And you can tell it's the top washer. It's just a little bit smaller than the bottom washer. So things look a little bit more proportionate if you have it on top. Feel it just lock in. I think I got an old board here. I'll take the hardware off of. Got some old Cam's wheels here. Tried and true classic, in my opinion. I have like 10 sets of these things now. You speed this part up. Oh, this is supposed to be a quick video. And there we have it. A tuned 34 millimeter China truck. Threaded. I would thread them all, but the amount that I sell, I can't keep up with that demand. So I figured I'd do the next best thing and teach you guys how to do it properly. So yeah, a little recap. No recap. Maybe just a slappy. Oh no, I can't. This is a giveaway board. I'm doing a giveaway. I'm willing to bet that's probably happening while I post this too. This is one of the giveaway boards. Go check out the giveaway on my Instagram. goo.ltd.com. Like, comment, subscribe, do the robot, do a kickflip. Horrible!